If you've read Amazon reviews recently, you've likely seen products with tons of reviews that include the same disclaimer. I received this item in exchange for an honest review. At Review Meta, we call these incentivized reviews. If you're suspicious of them, you're not alone, and as we're about to show you in this video, the data confirms that they have a massive bias. First, a little bit about ourselves and where we're getting this data. Review Meta is an independent company that analyzes online reviews and helps consumers identify which are honest and which might be less than honest. Our free online tool gives you a detailed report on any product on Amazon. We also recalculate the product rating after filtering out the suspicious reviews. Our tool has allowed us to collect a massive data set of over 18 million reviews. We use this to examine trends and provide you with aggregate statistics like the ones you're about to see in this video. So how can we automatically determine if someone received an incentive? We use an algorithm that looks for specific groups of keywords in the text within close proximity. A manual review shows that it's about 99.5% accurate. After compiling our data, we see that about 20% of the reviews in our data set are incentivized and 80% are not. The average rating of all incentivized reviews is 4.73 stars, while the average rating for non-incentivized reviews is 4.33 stars. This is a whopping 0.4 star difference. Now, 0.4 stars might not sound like that much, but keep in mind that the average product on Amazon is around 4.4 stars, and a 0.4 star boost can send the product from the 54th percentile to the 94th percentile, which is a substantial upgrade. Now, an obvious objection would be that we aren't controlling for the product. Sellers are probably sending out only their best products for review, so that would explain the discrepancy in rating, right? Wrong. Even when we control for product, we still see that the incentivized reviews are 0.36 stars higher than non-incentivized reviews for the same exact product. We looked at 807 products that had at least 10 incentivized reviews and 10 non-incentivized reviews, a total of 1.7 million reviews. Out of those 807 products, we found that 7% received a lower rating from their incentivized reviews, 6% received the same rating from incentivized reviews, and 87% received a higher rating from their incentivized reviews. So even for the exact same product, those who receive a freebie or a discount are generally rating it more favorably. Now, why is that? If you're thinking that reviewers may subconsciously feel indebted to a company for receiving something for free and thus are more likely to write a positive review, you're probably not wrong. However, we're not psychologists, we're data scientists. So let's instead examine where these reviews come from. Dozens of third-party review clubs have popped up in the last few years to facilitate the exchange of free or discounted products for honest reviews. This is fair game according to Amazon's terms of service, as long as a reviewer discloses this fact. While all review clubs operate differently, the main problem is that sellers can typically select who receives their products, which is the definition of selection bias. Reviewers are motivated to post positive reviews to keep the stream of free stuff flowing. This has given rise to some mega reviewers who have thousands of reviews under their belt and give almost exclusively 5-star reviews. For example, this user has over 1,600 reviews. All are 5-star except for one that is 4-star. In fact, we took a look at all reviewers in our database that had at least 10 reviews. We broke them up into two groups: reviewers who have written at least one incentivized review and reviewers who have never written an incentivized review. Those who had written at least one incentivized review were much more likely to write positive reviews in general. Now, you're probably wondering what can be done about all this. Our data shows that the problem has really gotten out of hand in the last 2 years. We're seeing that incentivized reviews currently account for more than half of all new reviews submitted to Amazon. You could manually scan each review, searching for the presence of a disclaimer, but what about products that have thousands of reviews? Well, we've created a solution, and it goes far beyond just picking out the incentivized reviews. Simply copy and paste the Amazon product URL into the search bar at reviewmeta.com, or you can use our browser extension, and we'll show you a detailed breakdown of the reviews. We automatically recalculate the product's average rating after removing the problematic reviews, so you can quickly see what's really going on. If you aren't satisfied with our analysis, you can even adjust our weighting and recalculate based on your own personal preferences. So next time you're reading reviews on Amazon, just remember what the data tells us and run the product through reviewmeta.com if you're having any doubts.